So I will share with you simple, practical stuff that you teachers need to prepare before doing online learning. Ito ay mga tips, lalong-lalo na sa mga gurong ngayon pa lang magsisimula ng online teaching. May panahon pa kayong maghanda. So pakinggan nyo yung nakaraang video, malaking tulong yon. At itong nang sasabihin ko sa inyo ay tatlong practical at easy things na dapat kung pwede gawin natin. I'm Ramil Benaventura. I'm a middle school math teacher here in New York since 2003. Tips for teachers who will start online learning. Number one, organize your work area. Be sure your desk is ready. You have all the needed things to facilitate online learning. So this is a sample work desk. You have your laptop, okay? And then there's a lamp, of course. A whiteboard could help you organize. Your writing materials are there. And then, of course, the document projector, calculator. And then beside me are the books, textbooks that I needed. Coffee, of course. And then I sit a TV, of course. I have it there. Sometimes I project the faces of the students there so I could see it in a bigger screen. And then on the right side, I'm near the window. Yay! It's also nice to have a good view and to have fresh air. Okay, so that's a work area, sample work area. Number two, have a planner, a diary, a notebook where you could write down all the things you need to do every day and a place where you could log all the accomplished work for that day. Okay, I started out very roughly before. I just wrote down random notes when we began March, okay? After that, I became more organized. Each page has a date. And then TTD, things to do, like there are always constant things that you need to do every day, and it also becomes a checklist, like the attendance. And then emailing for the announcement for Thursday. Okay, so that's the regular thing. I need to write that every day. And then this will be the extra works that you've done. You attended a meeting, what are your notes for the meeting? Okay, and if it's done, put a check all the time. So it's a reminder for you and a checklist as well, because there will be a lot of clerical work. There will be a lot of things to remember. A handy dandy notebook will be very helpful. Number three, a document camera. A document camera like this is a life-saving machine. Okay, so this is a document camera. Okay, it connects with a USB to your laptop over there. And then whatever you write down on the sheet of paper will be projected to your Zoom, okay? So if you don't have a document camera like this, I have a video on how to make a hack and produce a good document camera. You don't need to buy it, it's expensive. You could use your cell phone and your laptop and some wire, wireless or without wire, it is still possible. Check out my old videos. One mistake or one regret that I could have done better before this thing happened is to organize my Google Classroom. Before the lockdown, I already assigned students in my Google Classroom. But it's just there. I never used it. I never trained the kids how to do it. It's just there for announcements. But when this thing happened, I'm just happy I already have the listing by class. But I could have trained my students how to turn in homework. I could have trained the students how to check the classwork, how to check the assignments, everything. Maximize the use of Google Classroom even if there is no pandemic, even if there is no lockdown. Use it as often as you can and integrate it already in your regular face-to-face classroom work. Okay, advice to the teachers who will start online learning. Maghanda po kayo, prepare yourself. It is not that easy. Be ready for extra stress. Be ready to answer a lot of emails and correspondence with parents, with students. Always prepare. Do not face the class unprepared.